Hi everyone. In today's video, I'm going to discuss how to do an upgrade on a Mac Pro. Now, before you begin, there are a couple of things you're going to need to get started. First thing is you're going to need to purchase one of these items, which are a anti-static armband. And basically, this little device over here goes around your wrist. This attaches to a metal surface to ground you, so there's no static electricity when you're replacing the RAM. It's always a good idea to do this. It's not that you absolutely have to, but if you want to be extra precautious, it's a good thing to do. I'll send a link to you in this so that you could purchase one. They have them on Amazon for like $4 or $5, so they're not expensive, and you can use it in the future anytime you're doing replacements like these. So the next thing that you need to consider is what kind of Mac Pro did you purchase? Did you buy the 3.7 quad core or the 3.5 gigahertz 6 core? Depending on which one you bought, you're definitely going to want to get the RAM that is appropriate for those machines. They are configurable differently slightly, so you definitely want to keep that in mind. So if you bought the 3.7 quad core, it probably came with 12 gigs of RAM, which were 3 4-gig chips, which means that you probably have an empty slot on the fourth slot, and you could probably buy 1 4-gig chip to upgrade it and get it to 16 gigs. So there is the first configuration you can do, which is 4 chips, 1 chip in each slot, where there are 4 slots in the Mac Pro, and you can buy 4-gig chip and go from 12 gigs to 16. Now, if you wanted to go to 32, you'd actually have to remove all of the 4-gig chips, and you'd probably resell them on eBay or whatnot. And then you would purchase 4 8-gig chips to get you to 32 gigs. So it's not mixing and matching. You only have 4 slots, so you'll have to pull out the 4 gigs in order to go up to 32 and buy 4 8-gig chips. If you want to go to 64 gigs, again, you'd be pulling out your 3 4-gig chips and putting in 4 16-gig chips. So you'd need to purchase 4 16-gig chips to make 64. And obviously, down here on the 3.5, you've already would have had 16 gigs that came in it. You would then want to get either 4 8-gigs or 4 16-gig chips. Now, again, you're going to be pulling out the old 4-gig RAM chips and repurpose them or resell them. Now, there are some vendors who will buy back that RAM from you and give you a discount on the RAM you're purchasing. So you could look for that also with your retailers. I'll put a link to the RAM that I purchased for my upgrade so that you guys will know which RAM you could buy and see what the configurations are. So let's get started. Once you have the RAM and you have your anti-static band on, what would be the next step? Well, at this point, you would look on your Mac Pro for the lock, and here it is. You would slide the lock to the right and push down with your fingers and take off the top of the Mac Pro. At this point, you would rotate the Mac Pro and you would check for this little triangle and this little triangle, because that's where the RAM chips are, 2 on each side. You'd click it, then you would rotate the Mac Pro, which I did, and I found it easier to pull the chips out this way. Look for the slot. You have to align the slot to the slot inside the Mac Pro, because then you'll never put it in upside down, because that only matches one way. When you're ready to put it in, slip it back in the slot, press down until it clicks, and push. And that's all there is to it. There are 2 chips on either side. You would do the same on the other side, and when you're done, you would simply pick up your top, align the opening with the opening on the trash can, and lock it. And that's all there is to it. So basically, there are 2 chips on either side, one on top of the other. When you click out that triangle piece, you would actually be pulling 2 chips out instead of just the one that I did. But that's all there is to it. It's that simple. And if you buy the armband that I recommended, you probably won't have any anti-static issues coming on your logic board due to this upgrade. So I hope you enjoyed the video. It's as simple as that. And if you like it, please like it. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment. And thanks for listening.